Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous videos, you were introduced to A2Beauty in Flame 2019. A2Beauty's main purpose is beauty retouching, but with a few different settings, it can offer you a lot more than just its original intended purpose. In this video, you'll use A2Beauty to do the reverse of beauty work, so you can make skin look a lot worse than it really is, and this can be used for aging effects or enhancing special effect prosthetics like monsters and zombies. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your favorite web browser. Go ahead and load the media into a sequence. Now, before we work on the actress's skin, we need to grade the shot and mask out the area of her face. In the interests of time, I have supplied this as a setup. Switch to the Effects tab and press the Load button. Navigate to the downloaded media and load the Beauty Reverse setup file. So the shot simply has a cold-looking grade, and if you scrub the time bar, her face is already masked and keyed for the Selective Effect shader. If you select the image and choose Selective 2 in the HUD, you can press F8 for the Selective Matte view, and you can see the matte generated for her skin. Press F4 to return to the result view. Now let's apply the A2Beauty shader to Selective 2. Hold space and click on Selective 2 in the Selective Manager. In the File Browser, choose the A2Beauty Selective Effect shader. Now let's zoom in on her face. By default, the A2Beauty shader is smoothing the skin. You can see this more clearly if you toggle the H keyboard shortcut to turn Selective 2 on or off. If you click the A2Beauty tab in the controls and start adjusting any controls, the initial behavior is to smooth the skin. But if you click the invert button, the tools do the opposite. Lines and marks become more pronounced on the skin. Increasing the fix size pushes even more detail into the constrained region. Set the size to 150. If the lines don't match up correctly, you can adjust the ratio and angle of the fix until you get the effect you're after. Adjusting the details recovery amount allows you to blend back the original image onto the enhanced details. Now, to really push the damage and lines on the skin, increase the overdrive value. This will push all the values of A2Beauty much further and can be pretty useful in these cases. Now, if you scrub the time bar, you can see how the A2Beauty Selective Effects has really created a worn look. But one of the byproducts is that the highlights have too much contrast. So increasing the highlight slider under shading will blend the original highlights back into the face. The same can be done if you want to reduce the intensity of the shadows. Once more for comparison, toggle the H keyboard shortcut to toggle Selective 2 on and off. Let's return to the timeline view and process the result. So there you have it. A2Beauty can make people look much younger, and it can also make people look much older. As I mentioned in the beginning of this video, this could be used with practical special effects to enhance prosthetics even further. Loads of practical applications. In an upcoming video on A2Beauty, we'll take a look at how you can use the Selective Effects to clean up various textures. You can remove stains as well as smooth out wrinkles. All that to look forward to in the next video. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.